and all those kind of things like that. And with the Hunger Brothers, what we focus on, we like to go into different restaurants. Right. Specifically, we like to go to some of our restaurants that we enjoy in our communities. Right. And we go and we like to, you know, highlight their dishes, because in the Black community, we have a lot of great restaurants. And sometimes we don't get the publicity and the push that we do. So we want to come in, we want to blow your restaurant all the way up. So when we come in, you got some good chicken wings, let us know at the door that your chicken wings fire. And we come in there, we going to break them down, eat them, we going to dissect them, we going to do everything with them and put them out to the video for the rest of the people.
No Black man I know is thinking that hard about a chicken wing when he eating it. Is that for real?
Man, look.
I mean, yeah.
Is it really a science to the chicken
wing? It's an art. Break it down.
If I'm eating your food and I don't think about my childhood,
yes. Wow. You keeping it real, Charles.
I'm just saying.
See, she the queen. I'm not the queen. Now, you ever ate something so good, you close your eyes when you ate that first bite, you just close your eyes?
Yes.
If I can't close my eyes when I bite into your food the first time, it probably ain't going to happen the second time either.
Okay.
Like bite that paw. Like, and you squint your eye real hard.
Uh-huh. Okay, so we take a shift on, and I'm speaking up on not only the behalf of my show, Grown and Dating, because I want to ask this question for women everywhere. Is a man's heart truly in his stomach? Ramen noodles.
50-50.
75%. Brothers, sisters want to know where that other percentage is. It's in us. So
right.
So how we present ourselves. So if I show up and I'm crude,
right?
And I'm look crude, and I smell nice, I got it all together,
right.
And I got some homemade macaroni and cheese
is
over here.
Yeah, it gotta be baked.
Is it baked though?
I mean, what you mean? Is it baked? I'm a Mississippi girl. I don't know how to disboil stuff. What is this?
Okay.
I don't do no Velveeta stuff.
Oh,
you know.
Okay.
You know, it's a rice of passion. Yeah,
carry on.
It's a rice of passage. He's a carry on. It's a rice of passage in our household, like what you can cook.
Right.
You know, no measuring cups. You get in there and you make it.
True.
You get in there and you put it together. So, I mean, you said in the oven. I'm like, what other way can you
See, it's new school now, though. You guys got to, you know, it's new school.
The top got to be burnt ever so slightly.
Yeah, gotta be dark skin on top.
Oh, yeah.
A little bit.
Gotta be dark skin.
And how many cheeses?
Maybe five, six, seven, eight.
Seven.
Not seven.
Agiaso and Limburger. Well, you might not want to put some Limburger cheese over in some macaroni and cheese. You might not want to do that. It might not smell good. you might run dude out of the door. That might not be a good thing. So I guess to answer your question, sisters, if you're standing there with a peach cobbler and some macaroni and cheese, some greens, and some other stuff, then you got your lipstick on or whatever they like on, I guess that is the chemistry to a man's heart is not only in his stomach.
You got a sleeping bag. You could have had you a sleeping bag.
Charles.
Hey, make it a sleeping bag.
I hope you drove over there.
Bring the sleeping bag.
He said, don't expect me.
I hope she drove, because I'm going to sleep after that meal.
See, we all the way over. Because we starting this show off on a whole nother level. This boy said, don't expect me to do nothing. That no mac and cheese.
I mean, don't bring no movie to my let's chill.
That's a Netflix
and shit. Don't not watching nothing but my eyelids after that meal you just fed me.
And we gonna just have fun today. We thank you for kind of introducing yourselves, letting us know who you are in the community. We gonna change it up a bit. We're gonna talk about some stuff going on. The segment's called Gorgeous Around the Globe. And this is basically where we highlight what's going on around the globe. both positive and some things not so positive, unfortunately. You know, you have your yin and yang. We have great things happening in our world that people don't highlight sometimes.
Right.
And we also have things happening in the world that are bad. And it gets all the attention. And some things that are really bad that people don't care about at all.
Right.
We're going to start off with the good stuff first. We're going to smile first. We're going to give a big stylish behavior congratulations and shout out to none other than Pensacola designer Audrey Allen. She designed the A+ swimwear for us curvy girls, and she slays us as a bathing suit. She got me thinking about some stuff.
I think I saw.
I'm gonna have to wear some. She's
killing the game.
Sister was in New York this weekend at the CurvyCon 2016 this past weekend. And for those who aren't aware of what this event is, it's basically a platform for designers that's specifically designed for plus size ladies. The Pensacola designer, she participated and she had a pop-up shop that weekend. And that's big, because to take your designs to New York to be able to go and be in that level of an event, just to simply breathe the air for a designer. In the industry, it's always where you are. You a model, you know, it's always where you are.
Yeah.
It's always who's looking. D&J's favorite things is always who looking. You making sure you in the right place at the right time, because anything, you and I both know, Charles, anything can just happen with that. You can be in Walmart at the right time, and if Tyler Perry is standing there and you got a good side profile, you might be on one of these shows that's coming
up. Perry to call. Hey, Mr. Perry, if you listening.
There you go.
I am here.
There you do.
Voices got deep real quick, but that's me. I'm waiting for you, sir.
You hear? And I'm his agent. I am Queen Sara, CEO of D&J's Favorite Things. Yeah, we need do wardrobe.
Yeah.
So all the people listening in Atlanta, go on, spread
it. Yeah, the word.
Throw me that too. Look.
Sara being all humble about the thing, man. Look, I appreciate the mess out of her, man, because we ran into each other, and she told me, "Yo, I need you to come take a few pictures for me." Okay, cool. I'm thinking this small piece. You know, I'm just take a few pictures, model a few ties here and there. Okay, cool. Let's do it. Man, you don't understand the level of how I felt when I took those pictures.
Uh-huh.
And then she called me for a round two. Man, when a round two came, man, look, I'm just telling you, I felt like I had to make it. And then when we messed around and did the fashion show that the ladies of the commerce did, man, look.
That night was a night. That was all for everybody.
Night,
I seen those pictures, bro.
Oh, man, pictures don't do what we need to do for the feeling we actually had that night. Man, I'm talking about from the word go until it was over. Even after it was over, people stayed behind to take pictures, to talk, to politic. Man, look. Y'all got to hurry up and do another one. I mean, not one more. Two, three, four more. Because I enjoyed myself, you hear me?
And it was enjoyable. I was, last show, we talked to Paris. You know, she was behind the scenes, too.
Right, right.
And she was putting the sweet beat on all the models' faces. And no, Charles did not have on makeup. He is naturally beautiful.
Man,
but
put some makeup.
He had on cocoa butter.
Man, my forehead be shining, Jack.
I mean, really, Charles, dude. But not Charles slayed it. He walked out there. He made not tying a bow tie just a whole new trend. I've been seeing brothers walking around Pensacola with stuff untied.
That was a hollow situation.
Up at the church. Yes. And they know they hadn't worn it up at the church.
Man.
You know that first lady. You actually see that tie. Get that tie together before you get on that quad stand.
I don't know if it's that I don't know how to tie a bow tie.
I'm trying to be fly in the name of Jesus.
I can tie it sometimes. And sometimes it don't work right.
My bow tie be all loose.
Yeah, but
unless you buy the pre-tie when you're good. Then.
Yeah.
But yeah, that was a great platform for Audrey. And I'm very proud of her.
That's good deal.
One is sister of color, woman is a woman, period. And especially in the industry.
Right.
Because we often, as African Americans and even minorities, we don't necessarily get all the platforms, right. a lot of platforms to display our talents and our gifts. And that's why I do commend people who create platforms for us to right. function. And sometimes people don't understand, as being in the industry, you have to get your own hammer, nails, and wood and build your own platform. Yeah. And that's real. And that's why Stylish Behavior even came about. This is a place where, okay, we can say, okay, my name is Charles Gibson. I'm a model.
Right.
Because we might not get to a radio station here or a radio station there, but we have one here in Pensacola, Florida, and right. Real Women Radio that's giving people a platform to display their talent and to get closer and closer to their dreams of not just my Mississippi self flat foot living it. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
You have to. Like we talked about a little ways ago. Wait. I don't want to push you on too far. I want to talk about what she did. She created swimsuits for Curvy Sister, right?
Right.
Which is a good thing. Everybody's not made to have six packs and wear a size 3 jeans. I don't know the real size, but y'all, excuse me. I don't want to make
clearly.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's clearly he don't know like sizes. Like, okay, I'm gonna just put me out there because we Real Women Radio. I'm real.
Let's go.
I am a delicious size 18.
Man, that's a real size, like delicious size.
It is a real size for me.
Hey, I feel you.
I'm gonna go look in the store. See if they got a size delicious.
I'm gonna go ask,
ma'am. Y'all got a size delicious?
Yeah, you got the delicious 18 or the 15?
Look,
we got a size delicious, sir. Look, what is you doing?
Don't do me like that. I'll be the answer.
Get me arrested at the store for asking about the size delicious.
Yeah. These brothers in here, sir, cutting up today.
What doing, sir?
But I'm the delicious size 18, and you might have a beautiful size 20 or 24 or 16. And funny enough, I think it said the average size, even back in the 50s, for a woman was a size 16. Marilyn Monroe was a size 16.
Right.
She was bad, too. She was thick.
But what did you expect? Did you just hear that menu she gave? You ain't going to be no size 6 with that kind of menu.
If you a size 3 and 4, you making that kind of food.
You can't.
Your food bad.
No, it's not. We finna drive this back to the lane. They are running amok in the palace. Queen Sara gotta bring it to a head. I'm gonna take up because I have a friend and she is petite and she is from Macomb, Mississippi. I'm gonna tell you something. This girl made some ribs so good. The brother from New York told her, "You need to put the ribs in the mail. Can you drive ribs?"
I was about to say, let me find out.
You know about these ribs.
And we'll
dissect them.
And her name is Jocelyn. She probably even listening to the
Jocelyn,
show.
Jocelyn, we'll say, bring them ribs.
Help them ribs, though,
you
Jocelyn.
Let us know where to meet you at, and we'll get some of them ribs.
Yes, but the girl can throw down.
But
on a positive, note, we have, I would love to stay there, but we're going to also show some love for the brothers and sisters who lost their lives in Orlando. That was a tragic event. It was senseless. And my problem with not so much, well, is how people handled it. Mm-hmm. You know, at some point in time, I think people have to understand true consciousness is being humane. Right. And it's not that they were lesbian, gay, or whatever. Right. It's somebody lost their sister, cousin, brother, mama,
daughter. Son, whatever. Yeah.
And they don't care what they are. Right. I lost my child, or I lost X, Y, and Z, whoever I lost. And they're not thinking about all this political rigmarole, or like I tell my kid, rah, rah, boom, there's noise. They're not thinking about all this noise.
Right.
They're consciously thinking of, okay, this is what, this is how this affects me, this is the person I lost, and I'm going to have to grieve and deal with that. Right. So I encourage people to please keep those people in prayer, because they're going to need healing way past, when people stop putting the teddy bears out and when the cards fade, there's going to be a very empty place. A void. And I just want people to be so mindful of just being humane to people, because Cornel West said it best. You know, we can get to a point where we've truly reached and gotten the point when we stop crying for the child because it's black or it's white or it's navy blue. We have to start crying for the child when the child is hungry.
Right.
That should be the underlying issue we have with people being mistreated.
You made a great point. Also, you know, when that happened, I remember people, the first thing they did, instead of saying, you know, hey, you know, some people were hurt, you know, praying or something. First thing people was out, it's a conspiracy. You know, it's there. It wasn't 50 people killed. It was 18. You know, that kind of stuff. When you're, when that's not affecting your family and you can say that kind of stuff, you know, you can say it don't feel bad. But if my child was one of those people that was killed,
right,
and I get on Facebook and you saying it's all a hoax, you know, it's this and that, that's a different kind of hurt.
Right.
Because if my child was dead in that and you say it's a hoax, I'm saying, what's fake about, you know, burying my child?
Because I'm, and I got to jump in, brother. Because you know when this dude was running and snatching people's kids up, now I'm motherhood. I'm just gonna put it out. Y'all see the rage in me already. Brother got the camera on me. See, I'm already tight. Cause I got two, and I don't mind wearing stripes. Yeah, that would be stylish behavior. Right. Your girl, the orange will be the new black. Cause I do not play about the Shazer. Hey Shazy and Jabria. Hey Jabria. I don't play about my children.
Oh yeah.
I will. What? But I saw that clip where that man was dragging that baby through. Woo. And I thought, and the whole time I'm thinking, how many pieces, first of all, how many racks I'm finna pick up and kill you with?
Oh, you sitting up in the store when he tried to steal the
I read off, and it's funny, I was reading comments on Facebook, and women who I know are mothers, and I have everybody on my Facebook page in terms of friends, black, white, navy blue, Muslim, folks is like, okay, I'm gonna take you out. Call the police.
Yeah, no,
he dead. I'm taking him out.
Yeah. I don't. We not finna wrestle with my child.
We ain't finna wrestle.
We ain't finna. I'm a grab my child.
Yeah,
I'm gonna tell him to stand right here because we ain't got nothing to talk about. If you try to steal my child,
right?
I mean. Yeah.
call the authorities. That's what he's called.
I'm gonna call him on myself after the situation goes down, sir. You need to come in and arrest me.
Because what kind of mindset?
You need to come get me
now.
You need
to come arrest me because I just did something. I probably gonna regret later on. But don't mess with the kids, man.
Yeah, and that's why you have to be so mindful of when you have your kids, social media, how you present your kids.
Yes,
because you don't know the mindset of people. Like, what kind of mindset will make you go to Walmart or somewhere and say, "I want that child"?
You know,
you know what I'm saying? You know, so. With social media, also, I see my friends and stuff. I have a daughter. She's new. But I don't like to post a lot of pictures of myself.
And I don't
pictures.
Either. You are absolutely right there. Because I have a business. And I don't, even though my business, the initials are named for them, I don't use my children's picture to promote my business.
Right.
I don't do that. Like, okay, you see my children. They at the beach cute.
Right.
But it's on private settings, and guess what? Only y'all can see because y'all my friends.
Right.
But people getting people's kids, and you a business, and you haven't talked to both parents about how you're disciplining their children, and you're sending their children up the creek too. And I think that's a mindless and really sick person to not think about the welfare of a child. Yep, I'm mad right now. not think about the welfare of a child. That's some stuff you don't do. And I don't care what law has been written or unwritten or what agreement. It's some things we got to get back to common sense.
We got to get back to common sense
and how we care about our community. But we don't care because we've turned into the I generation and we want to be seen. And all this superficial stuff that don't mean nothing at the end of the day. Yep, I'm going off. And then another thing, as mothers, we have to stop saying, oh, if it wasn't my child. If it's what, no, you need to think that way because I think of it just as simple. I wouldn't want anybody else's child to suffer. I wouldn't want that mother to suffer. I wouldn't want that father to suffer. And we have to pull our heads out of this hole that we have created ourselves. So we think we're important now.
Right.
We got this exaggerated sense of importance, and we don't want to know what we should do to protect our community and protect our children so they can have a life and all this extra stuff. I digress. Yes. I'm going off.
But to jump on when you jump back.
Because I'm getting heated over here.
But to get where you at, some of the women, as a man, if I saw somebody, as a man, looking to take somebody else's child, Me as a man, how could I sit and watch another guy do that?
And how you videoing it?
How, you know, how do you video that?
How you video that?
You know what's crazy? You know? That's the question I asked. Who was recording this situation? But I think it was a store camera.
But
people was around.
I didn't see anybody else jump in to help. That's what had me.
And it's a woman.
Where everybody else at?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So.
Right.
A lot of stuff I see on Facebook and Instagram, whatever the case may be, it behooves me because, like, who is recording these situations and just standing back allowing this stuff to take place?
Right.
They're just letting stuff happen. But on a lighter note, because I didn't get toasted.
Yeah, I'm gonna tell my
coat on. I don't play. My skin is literally hot.
Bring in a fan.
I don't play about children. I've always been passionate about children, right, even before I had my own. I'm wired that way. My father loved children. My parents, civil rights activists, so they believed in, okay, everybody, you gotta have a better shot in the world.
Mother instinct.
Yeah. And I'm really hot over here. But let's talk about something light. But we gotta get back to a place. We need to play some music something up and through here.
Man, we gotta cool play the temperature.
I'm about ready to go outside and watch something.
I done got what they say in Mississippi.
They got fired up.
I done got full thought of hot.
Hotter than a six shooter.
Like, for real. But anyway, another thing.
Burning hot.
I'm sorry. I'm gonna say this, and I'm going to go into this next news article. You don't mess with a woman or even a man. You don't mess with a woman who is prepared to die for her children.
Come on,
that is some dangerous stuff.
Mm. Oh yeah.
You don't want to cross that line. I digress. Now, this sister here, Teen, she designed an African print prom dress. You know how everybody was tripping about the prom dresses.
This young sister
designed a prom dress, and guess what? It's been featured in Vogue, Glamour, and Allure. So kudos to her. 19-year-old, I cannot pronounce her name. I know it's McIntyre. Kaimaya McIntyre. Mm-hmm. She's going to be featured in a Dove campaign celebrating natural hair. So shouts out to Miss McIntyre. I hope I'm pronouncing her name right. A young woman, she's positive. Embracing her culture, and look at how the universe and God kiss you back when you embrace yourself.
Yeah,
you gotta be you.
Quit trying to be everybody else.
Can't
nobody beat you at being you.
Right. I know that's for real. So. I think they would be tired of that with me, because I need 3 or 4 naps. You know, you don't appreciate naps and sitting down until you get grown.
Telling you, I posted about naps the other day. I say, naps, I'm sorry I hated you as a kid.
And we're not talking about naps in your head,
not
y'all.
We're
talking about naps that you take.
The power naps.
Like 3, 4 o'clock for some reason. I don't know, man.
But we're gonna take a music break so I can cool off from this heated discussion.
You got mad. I was scared.
And look, Charles looking at me like,
I got scared.
Charles sitting over here looking at me like,
I ain't never seen this side.
What is wrong with this girl?
Yeah, she started turning red. You know,
did I really turn red? Stop telling that tale.
She light skinned it.
We gonna talk about that too.
They turn pink. They mad.
See, I'm gonna throw him out of my studio. He cutting up. But anyway, we're still highlighting, believe it or not, we're still highlighting etiquette and culture. And y'all, it's raining men. It's raining men on Styles and Behavior. We have Theo Thomas and we have Charles Gibson in the place. Mr. Gibson Church.
In the building.
He in the place. I love this fella. Anyway, we are going to go to a song right now. I'm scared to tell y'all which one because I'm still kind of new on this equipment.
Just start it. They'll pick it up.
We're going to start it and we're going to pick it up. Here we go.
Watching the people around, baby, please come home. The church bells
in
town, they're ringing a song. What a happy sound! Baby, please come home. They're singing, deck the
sing. You know, I can, but I don't think you got the right to sing.
The children are the future. All the fun we had last year. Me and my music. Pretty
lights on the tree. Watching them shine. You should be here with me. Baby, please come home.
Baby, please come home. We gonna keep it going and keep it going. No, we gonna push on. Alright. Now we'll be right back. Me and Sarah's back. We're gonna work out that technical difficulty we had, but it's okay. We're gonna keep it going and keep it going here on Real Women Radio. This is your lady. We are listening, we're listening to Stylish Behavior. We have Charles Gibson and Theahmad Thomas in the building. And we are talking about how to treat women in etiquette. We're trying to get some music that's themed around it now. She is consistent. She always tells us what we need to do and what we don't need to do. Education around here. What too? Both profound, both real raw. So I don't really sound with raw. She needs, I love her. She needs like a throw lock in the second. I said, and I love me some L Bridges, but my girl was going through the thing. This is franchise.
They probably had an accident.
You know, on the funny note, you know they say when Aretha Franklin performs, she actually makes everybody cut off the air. And it's like they say it's the hottest, funkiest, most wonderful experience to hear her perform, because they said the building is like hot.
It's gotta sound good.
It's a different
it's
kind of
heat. It sound good.
Short said that's going
it's a whole different kind of heat. But yeah, we're getting back into Stylish Behavior. You're here with Queen Sara. Make sure you follow me, Queen Sara, on Stylish Behavior on Facebook. Make sure you follow me, Favorite Things 100 on Instagram. I'm always throwing up different jewelry, different fashions. And guess what? You'll see pictures of Charles all over the place, because he is the male face of D&J's Favorite Things, baby. Get tied up. Yes, he is Mr. Get Tied Up. There you go.
And Mr. Charles, the face, can I be the arm or something like that?
You be the arm.
I need to get in. I need the arm model or something.
You know what? We want to put a sleeve on
the
shirt.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We got to get Theo up in there.
Some cow muscles in the suit.
We got to seriously get him up in there. We're going to drive this car in a different direction. We're going to get all in Charles' business before. Charles' business. Okay, you as a model and an artist. I've worked with you on several occasions. I've seen you do around town. I've seen you involved in different things. What inspires you, or why did you even want to become an actor or even get into the entertainment industry?
Okay,
you say you it's a spark that inside you say, this is something I have to do, this is something that just has to happen, this is something I desire to do. What inspires you? Well, I mean, you feel light, but what inspires you?
What inspires me now? I gotta give props.
For the first set, boy, I was a hustling sister behind this stage.
I know that's the girl.
But she is brilliant. I love her.
Wow.
I don't know. It's intense.
Yeah.
It's, the writing itself is intense,
yes.
And then the vibe of family. And I'm gonna say stuff. I'm gonna push it. I'm gonna let you get back into it. What I love the most about the industry family that has been created here in our circle, we have a good time. Like Set Life, I don't know how they do it in California. I don't know how they do it anywhere else, but Set Life in Pensacola is a whole, we are laughing. The makeup artist can't get your lipstick on straight because somebody laughing about something. It's just a good time. I was on the set with Devin Tucker, Brian Daly. Oh my God, he is like, y'all gotta book these folks. Brian Daly is like, his regular pictures, he didn't have to edit anything. The man, right. The boy has the Midas touch. Whatever he, whatever shot he snaps just turns into gold. Well, and then Bobby Booker,
the picture of mine, right?
Yes, and Bobby Booker. We have some talented photographers in there. Yeah, Bobby is on point. Shout out to B&B Productions, baby. Book, he another lock. He another lock, brother. Yeah, we all up in. I love Bobby. I know we all in there deep.
Got comfortable. I know. Girls sleep on the couch.
I'm like, where chicken at? You playing?
Eat some chicken.
You know what?
We ain't smell no pots burning. Look, yeah, I got upset.
And Bobby, if you listen, I'm still waiting on my barbecue chicken. But I digress. We're gonna go back. We're gonna talk about you because it's about you, baby. We're talking about you. Nah. Now, to ask another question, I hope I'm not fast forwarding too far.
Mm-hmm.
In the industry, there are difficult aspects. Lord knows there are difficult aspects.
Right.
How do you deal with that?
With difficulties, the only really difficulties I ran into as far as acting wise is just learning everybody. Because you have to learn people to have chemistry.
True.
On stage.
True.
Not even just on stage, it's actually through rehearsals.
Right.
And if you have a cast of, I don't care how many you have, if you have a few people in one cast, you have to allow everybody to come in with their own ideas. And the biggest thing about us, I'm going to say, is a lot of us have that takeover spirit.
Yes, Lord.
Come in with the takeover spirit as of, this my show. Yeah, you may have the most lines in the play.
Right, right.
You are not the star of the play.
Right. Well.
You have that one person think that they're the star, it's over.
Right.
Yeah, they'll kill the play. They'll kill a vibe in the play. It's been plenty of plays I've had a lot of lines.
Mm-hmm.
But, Charles, I'm very observant.
Right.
I sit back and I watch people.
Right. Right.
And if I feel like, you know what I mean, this one person has that takeover spirit or this my play spirit, I kind of draw away from them because I don't want you to kill my vibe because I have to actually get into my lines outside of rehearsal and at rehearsal.
Right.
I actually learned that from Will Smith. I heard how he learns everybody play in the movie. I mean, everybody parts in the movies he's in.
Mm-hmm.
That's hard.
Learning
your own lines by itself is enough.
Right.
To learn everybody else's lines, that's crazy.
But I sit back and I listen, not only for my lines, mm-hmm. but I listen for everybody else's lines. And when I come in, how I'm going to come in. Man, I'm telling you, my people at work, when they know when I'm in a play. Cause they
right,
know,
right.
Man, you talking to yourself again.
Nah, yeah.
I'm going off my line.
Because you mind. you getting in your head and you getting it right and you getting ready. Exactly. And that's cool. That's cool that you're mindful of that. What advice would you give to a person, a young person? I believe it's never too late to start something good. Right. What advice would you give to a person who's trying to act, who's trying to model?
You just have to. The biggest advice I would say to anybody is you have to believe in yourself. Because if you acting or modeling, whatever the case may be, whatever you want to do, you're not going to always get the yes you're looking for.
Right.
You're not going to always, whenever you go for something the first time, you may not have what this producer or this artist, whatever, is looking for. Keep pushing. You can't stop at the first note. I don't stop at the first three notes. My wife got me like that.
Right.
You have to call me 37 times. And she's going to call you back a 30.
38 and a half.
I'm telling you, that's how she operates.
I love Jennifer. That's my girl.
That's how she has me. She don't take no for an answer. You have to put in her spirit that this no is what you got to go with this time.
Right.
Just this one time. She'd be mad about that. That's how you gotta put
it. Jennifer, hold up, Jennifer. I ain't still trying to say that. Okay, all right, we cool. Okay.
Me too, Jennifer. I'm cool.
Okay.
Yeah, you gotta push on, man. You gotta believe in yourself, and you gotta motivate yourself.
All
if you
right.
don't motivate yourself, ain't nothing happening.
And most important question of this interview: what is your stylish behavior? Mr. Gibson.
My style is big. I don't know. I don't really have a style per se.
No, he got all the styles. He got A.
I put them all together.
He got B, C, D, E.
I put them all together, man.
So modest.
If I find something I like, I'm going to buy it. I don't care.
He being so modest. I seen his brother. I was in Burlington, and I was not cute that day, so I was real under the radar. I was not Queen Sarah. And my sister spotted you. She said, "Who is that?" And Charles, he didn't realize he was standing like just a statue. He was just, and five other women were like drooling. Jennifer walked out and we, "Hey girl," and he's standing there like just the black male model. He's being very, very modest, folks. Being very modest. And the thing I love about him, and I think is his stylish behavior, he's just a beautiful personality. Because usually he has pretty people, because he is pretty as he want to be. And he has a personality and a spirit and a God-fearing man to all of that match. And I'm like, yes! You know, he's just a great guy. And I most definitely think that's his stylish behavior. He is wonderful. He is as beautiful inside as he is out.
Now,
and
Miss Gibson will tell you something totally different. Let her tell you.
You spoil.
She told me to sit down for all the time.
Sit down.
Yes, indeed. we're gonna try our best this time. My kingdom of beautiful people to get a song up and through here. Okay, we're gonna get a song. We're gonna come back and we're gonna talk to brother Theo. Theo sitting in the cut, because I'm gonna tell y'all they got camera crew and stuff in here. They came in here Hollywood all the way, and I'm like, okay, they made me get my bling block out. That's why I'm cute today.
I'm extra cute today.
I had to take my locks out of the turban. I had to put the sweet beat on. You know, I'm like, I had to be teen. Had to be cute. They're the other brothers that's hungry. And guess what? We're going to find out. We're going to do two things. We're going to find out about Brother Theo, what he got going on. We're going to talk about how we treating these women. Or how you going to teach these brothers how to treat these women. That is what we're doing. Who's singing that? They're not here.
I don't know no more words.
Here we go.
To your spirit when you're hungry. You know, if you hungry right now, you can't even focus at work. You know, I can't wait. Your mind slip. You be like, no, I can't wait to get off work. And so what we like to do is, you know, we using the hunger word, but we breaking it down. And we going back to our roots. If you want to be get real personal with it, going back to our roots and how we all came together as community to eat, fellowship, tell jokes, have fun.
Right.
And to learn about our culture if we taking it that deep. And so that's basically what we like to do. And we have fun doing it. And like I said earlier, we like to promote our restaurants, our people. Mm-hmm. People like yourself who got a radio show.
That's what's up.
You know, it's more than just food. But food is always around most of the time where we at. So we just want to...
It's a chicken wing. Yeah, you know. I have an obsession with chicken. See? Anyway, there's a chicken wing laying around somewhere.
Who don't have an obsession with chicken?
I got it.
Chicken always put a smile on your face.
It does. You're just happy.
Next time we come here, we're going to bring
you a
bowl
of chicken. Every time chickens see us, they run.
It's not a black folks thing. Nah, I promise you it's not a black, folks thing. We in the South. Everybody like chicken.
Unless you don't eat meat.
You don't eat meat. Shout out to the vegans.
Everything tastes like chicken. Yep. So...
Right. It really does, because it does. It tastes like a refined chicken. I was in Pennsylvania and had turtle stew.
Okay.
And it tastes like a refined chicken. And I'm like, so went to Indian Palace. My professor was eating, and he was like, Dr. McNeil, what does it taste like? He said, it tastes like chicken. Right. So.
Hey, man, why are we on it? We're going to let two of the other Hunger Brothers introduce themselves.
And they're going to jump in this conversation real quick. Knock it out.
What's going on, everybody? It's Dimitri. I'm the video guy. Boy, Theo pretty much pulled me in front of the camera. It's all good. We all in this together.
That's up.
And now that we in there, we're gonna draft y'all in here. Y'all can get smiles, you can give thumbs ups, you can give all this. We're gonna jump into the discussion. The question of the day was, I asked on Facebook, and I said the person's comment would be read. And thank you, Latoya Newsom. She answered the question. Basically, we ask, what is it that you like for your man or a man to do for you? It doesn't have to necessarily be romantic or be your spouse or significant other.
Right.
Basically, she said, I like it when he opens the car door. And I can give amen for this. I like it when she said, I like it when he cooks dinner or cleaning before I'm home from work. I can appreciate that. I can so appreciate that. I know
that's good.
Yeah, I know me personally. I like when you remember stuff. Like, I'm weird.
Oops.
What is it called? I'm attracted to people who are intellectually out just there.
Right.
So when you like remember stuff, and especially stuff I don't think good you stuff. Should remember. Like no, like really. I'm like, what? Like I need to. Yeah. Not favorite colors, like stuff that I'm not thinking about, stuff I didn't even notice about myself, and you make preparations for that same thing to happen.
That sounds like a movie thing.
Yeah.
Like she supposed to make some fried chicken and she didn't get the seasoning, and you went and copied that stove.
You went and got
the
seasoning.
They so silly. Like
chicken so much. No, but
they clowned me. I had a peach cobbler. That's funny.
He's Daryl the peach cobbler.
I'm peach cobbler and ice cream boo-boo. But we gonna get into this. We gonna stay focused.
Right. You said one thing you like.
How to treat women. How should your woman be treated? We're gonna start off with Theo because Charles has chopped it up.
How should you treat a woman as a man? You should treat... Well, first, I was taught that you should treat your woman, your girlfriend, whoever it may be, as you like to treat your moms. Because not too many men going to treat their moms like trash.
Right.
True.
At first, I didn't believe that until, you know, a couple of times. Like, you treat your mama like that? And I was like, hold on, wait a minute. It got personal. I thought about it. I said, man, would I do my mom like that? And it was like, okay. So, treating them how you would treat your mom, and also with respect. Respect. Everybody say they want respect and everything.
Put some respect on it.
Yeah, put some speck on it. But everybody don't do it, especially as a man, you know, in my time frame of being a not so good, man. I didn't respect a lot of females, not their opinions and different things like that, because I was the man. Mm-hmm. But a lot of times, the smallest things, like you say, remembering things, listening, that's the hard thing, though. It's easy, but it's hard to listen. And, you know, that's just the top two things that you as a man you have to do. Because if you don't, somebody will say, I bet you don't remember this. And when you don't remember it, the rain finna come.
You know what? I'm remember to pay the bill. You can forget. No. Remember to pay the bill.
Right.
You can forget that I told you to get some milk on the way home from work.
Right.
But if you remember that little bit of stuff that messed with me, like the little bit, I ain't talking about that kind of stuff. But they watching me. They watching me. And yes, I'm thinking about my Osiris while we were talking about this.
You remember
stuff that I had no idea you should even remember. Just I'm like, oh my goodness. Anyway,
and that come with listening.
I digress. I don't know if it was listening, just really great
attention.
Observation.
Paying attention.
Yeah, I'm just okay.
Paying attention.
Okay.
Yes.
I'm so like. Okay. Anyway,
flush.
I am.
She's
flabbergasted. I am. I'm gonna stop grinning.
And it's hard for a man to admit that. You know, it's hard for a man to say, "Yeah, I gotta respect you better. I gotta listen more and pay attention." Because all pride will tell me, "Man, I heard what you said. I heard it yesterday."
Yeah, this is true.
Mm-hmm.
But to say, "I gotta pay attention more." I'm sorry. Well, yeah. that make you just like, oh. But it take a lot out of a man to even admit to something like that, you know. So
yeah.
I had to do it a lot, you know.
And that's just being a man. That's just being.
It hurt your pride too. I came front, you know.
Yeah.
Wow.
To see a smile on her face, it
makes
you feel
builds you up though.
Yeah, that smile, you know what I mean? It cheer you up
to see that smile, because it's a lot of stuff, you know. I say women still have to give men credit for a lot of stuff that we do.
Right.
I mean, I hear a lot of women breaking down on stuff that they men don't do. You know what I mean?
Mm.
Or man, I play my video game. I'm going to tell you early.
Me three.
I'm on the PlayStation. I'm going to let you have it.
Yeah.
But in the same light, like I heard one of her friends say, would you prefer him to be playing the video game or out that clown?
Or playing the streets.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? But I'm not going to sit there and play 4 or 5 hours.
I take video games for 500, Alex.
But yeah, it's a lot of stuff. Even for when you say how a man treats a woman, and it's different aspects to me about that anyway. You know what I mean, right. I'm gonna treat you like you're supposed to be treated, and all men are guilty of, you know what I mean, not giving you the whole 100%. You know what I mean. And all women are guilty, not giving the man 100%.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to put the shoe on both sides.
Right.
I'm going to give you what Charles can give you.
Okay.
Don't go looking at, my friend so-and-so, our bank account might not be the same.
Ooh.
I mean,
say you're talking, brother. You
can't
talking.
Go buy you an Audi. Hey, he bought an Audi. Congratulations.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm glad God sent me the wife that I got, because she not real big on a whole lot of things. You know what I mean? She'll say something.
Right.
I'm gonna hear you. I ain't gonna buy it this week. I'm gonna let
Let it marinate. Let it marinate.
And let you think, oh, he remember what I said. Yeah, I did.
You hit it on the head though, man. You can't compare your relationship to other people.
Right.
Sometimes a lot of females, they end up saying, my homegirl, her man went to the Bahamas.
Right.
They went to Africa.
Right.
We went to Gulf Breeze.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's like, hey, you better enjoy that Gulf Breeze.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
Next time we may go somewhere else, but it's about building confidence.
Right.
If your man give you something small, he can't do nothing better, but he give his all at it.
Right.
And you good. Now when he bounce back and get right.
It's that meme I see on Facebook all the time. He gave you $200 and he dogging you out, but he gave you $20, but that was his last.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I see that all the time.
If you don't appreciate it, he gonna snatch it back. You know what I'm saying?
Now I'm gonna drive this in a different direction.
Right.
Appearance. Do you serious? Do guys really, really treat women different based on appearance? Like, do women who like seriously? If you see, because I'm throwing myself out there, I have been told I look expensive, and I have been told that by my brothers who are intellectual. I've been told that by my brothers who are jugheads. Yeah,
right.
We got some.
Right.
You look expensive, and I'm like, well, why? They said because you are. If they told me I look expensive, I don't think. I mean, I'm not cheap, but
right.
I think I look expensive.
I can get where it come from, but you know, a lot of cats, man. And it kills me. A lot of these brothers are intimidated by a female that got something going with them, for themselves.
Okay.
What?
That's the word.
Yeah. Okay, just tell me.
If my wife was to bring home more money than me, you think I care? I am happy.
Right.
I don't know what nobody else talking about.
Right.
Keep it real.
Charles, you keep it real.
I don't get how, and you got some women out there that are well off.
Yeah.
They got the house, they got the good credit, they got the 2-3 cars. Mm-hmm. And some cats get intimidated by that.
Right. Yeah.
Why? I have no idea. But that's the mind frame of some cats, man. Because it's, oh man, if she the breadwinner, that means she can tell me to get out whenever she wants to. Well, you don't give her a reason to tell you to get out.
Right. Well, yeah.
I'm going to jump on what you said. Me and my wife, man, she looked expensive. When I seen her, she put up in the Benz, you know. I was like, oh. But the confidence in me was like, man, but you still you, brother.
Right.
You still you, big fella. Right. You know what I'm saying? You got to be yourself. And he said that kind of intimidating. That's, you know, society tells us that the man must make more than the female. The man must take control, which the man is the head of the household. But society tells you, and your group of friends, your community can also tell you how you're supposed to be, but they're not that way. And so with men, a lot of times, we got homeboys that don't even got a lady. And like, man, shoot, dog. This is what you need to do.
Right.
And the same thing with females also. They got the homegirls that probably had, you know, boyfriends or something.
That ain't had them.
Yeah.
I don't play that.
And that's a lot of times that happens to some couples, and that if you're not equally yoked on that end,
right?
But the mindset, not physical things like that, well, you end up getting broke down because your friends and everybody, you know, everybody don't be loyal. That's my homegirl. I know her since second grade. She's been single since second grade.
And you know what, brother? That's in business and life. You can't take everybody with you
because
you can't kick it with the same people you kicked it with in the third grade. And and I'm gonna just be real. If you kicking it with some of the same people, you kicking it with in the third grade, and especially if they don't have that mindset, that speaks a lot about where you have traveled in your life.
Right.
Like, seriously, it's some people, and you don't mean to leave them behind, but we all branch off, and things change, and you know, sometimes for the better, sometimes for the worse. People get salty with success. Some people cannot handle success. I mean, even when they walk into it, they lose their minds, and they start smelling themselves, and you're like, okay, you go stand over there without it. But you know,
and with success.
Yeah.
You said that with success.
Yeah.
The part of it, men being intimidated a lot of times can be, or the other way around, is the success. If someone is, let's say you graduated, you got your master's degree in sociology and some old stuff, and I'm the guy, I'm getting ready to go to college, but you know, I want to talk to you. The intimidation factor would say, man, I can't speak to her because she just got her master's. I ain't got my bachelor's yet. But it comes a point in time where you got to say, look, because some females wear their accolades around their head.
On their shoulders.
Yeah, on their shoulders, but some keep it on the inside. And that's why I love my wife. She's a doctor, but she don't go around saying that, hey, I'm a doctor, so-and-so.
You know.
You never know that.
And I can speak for that because for a long time when I dated guys, I did not tell them how lettered I was. I'm like, okay. And I dated one guy. He was like, okay. He said, I couldn't figure it out. He said, you different. I couldn't figure it out. I said, well, I got 4 degrees. My highest is the master's. Right. He was like, that's what's going on. How come you just say something? Right. He said, I'm trying to figure out this chick different. Why is the chick? She different. Okay, I'm like, well, maybe that's the difference. He said, and you humble about it. That's what's up. I said, and the thing is, you get so, and what people don't understand, it's not even about, on the humble tip, it's not about trying to make your man look bad or make other brothers look bad. Shoot, we got to do that just to break even. Because what folks don't understand is sisters make like a percentage of what our counterparts make. So we have to have all these degrees and stuff just to get break even. Just so they'll look at our resume. Right. Just so we'll get considered. And it is not about being cocky because the master's degree, degree program or a PhD program is a very humbling experience for an African-American woman. You will have so many people telling you what you're not along that way versus behind you cheering you on. And that's probably one of the loneliest and most isolated times in a black woman's life, in her career, when she is trying to get a professional degree. And I can amen that because I done had a few of my friends like pet me down in the crowd. Oh, they call me dumb because they go at you. They, it's like,
it's, I don't professional now.
They go after your soul. It's like, okay, you know, you are dumb. You ain't gonna make it. Boop, 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 boop. They go after you. And if you a sister and you are conscious,
right?
Oh, yeah, you get filet. I got grilled all the time. How you know anything about African American studies? You pseudo, you graduated from Ole Miss, and you down there with white folks. They don't know nothing about being black. What you got to do?
Sometimes from your own people.
From your own people.
For the most part, that's where it comes from, and that's bad.
Yeah.
And like you said about success.
Right.
Not just, I think we have a huge problem with other black people being successful.
We do.
Mm-hmm. And that's horrible.
Right.
That when people say crab in a bucket mentality, it's real.
It's real.
It's all too real, and it's sad to say, and it pains me to know this stuff goes on a daily basis. Right.
And it's not improving, and even amongst women, amongst women in the workplace, if sister could be just brilliant, and I've experienced this, you have a law degree from Yale, and I'm just trying to get through my oral comps, and you got a problem. I'm like, really? Like, you from Yale.
Right.
What is the competition?
Right. What is the
You should be helping me.
You should be helping me. Exactly. And that's, you know, I've experienced that, and I've seen, you know, if a sister in the office and she cute, everybody can't stand her because she thinks she fine. No, the sister look nice.
Yeah, I think she fine.
She pulled together.
Because you don't understand what a person went through to get to that point. Right. If somebody could have been, say, your girl was 3 and some change 2 years ago.
Right. Mm-hmm.
If she lost weight to get down to 1 whatever, of course she know what stuff that make her, that shows, look what I work for.
Right.
But all people see is the end result, and then they bounce off that, and I'm talking bad about you right now because you look better than me.
Right.
I was going to say the D word, but there's gyms.
We don't have an FCC room. We can
go work out and look just like them. You got to put the work in it. People, they kill me with that. Even myself. Man, I can't go nowhere with Charles. Man, he always wants to dress this certain way.
Yeah.
You can go shop and do the same thing.
Yeah, he ain't no dress code.
They got 24-hour gym if you want to try to go work out and get to that point too.
Right.
Come on, man.
I'm about to go a little bit. Being around you, I'm about to go to the gym.
See, there you
I know.
Go.
I know. I don't know.
There you go.
But, you know, in driving back into in the main topic, men treating women different because their appearance, like if a sister's not so attractive, or she just, I'm not saying not so attractive, I'm going to say just not pulled together. I believe all women are beautiful on some level or another. Maybe she hasn't tapped into her beauty, but I do believe
maybe
that.
Maybe she just ain't your eye candy.
But let me
she's somebody eye candy.
Let me tell you something about that situation.
I believe you just tapped into
that. That kills me because, and I've seen both sides of it.
Right.
You can be beautiful as you want to be. Mm-hmm. You can go to the gym, you can do whatever you need to be. Mm-hmm. If your attitude stinks,
right,
your whole situation stinks.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have nothing to do with you if you're pretty and then you got a nasty attitude.
Right.
But then if you have this sister who thinks she's not that attractive, but when I say
she humble with it,
very humble,
right?
And I can introduce her to the fellow Matt. That's the biggest thing.
Now, child. I got to ask you this. Okay, have you ever seen a sister just from a distance?
Right.
Because I heard this. I was listening to Grown and Dating a few weeks ago, and I heard V. I'm putting you out there. V said they were at a venue, and a really attractive woman walked in, and he said him and some more folks. I'm sorry, V. I love you. But anyway, he said the first thing they said, "What's wrong with her?"
That is
she too fine.
That is a thing.
Sometimes it can be too fine.
Sometimes people say that. I've heard some sisters say that. Mm-hmm. Something is wrong with him. He's too perfect.
Right.
What is too perfect?
Right.
What does that even mean?
Wow.
But it's a lot of time it's true, though.
That is so jacked up.
A lot of time it's true.
I'm going to tell you why that's jacked up. Because when I first moved to Pensacola, I didn't know nobody, right? And I don't go, y'all see, I try to put myself together. I think for the most part, I'm an attractive woman. I really do. I do. I love, and I believe it. Okay. I'm humble about it.
Sarah, Mike, I'm attractive.
I am attractive.
Get dressed up and put a suit on and say, man, I'm good.
But you know what? I aim at having a beautiful spirit because I know that's going to take me a lot further. When this wrinkle and this fade and I'm tired of drawing lipstick on, I know my spirit is going to take me a lot further.
Only so far. Right. Your character can push you on though.
Right. But going back into my point, I had to go to network. I went to networking events by myself because I was trying to build a business. Right. I didn't know anybody in Pensacola, so I'm just going to show up. Now, and I'm wondering, when I was showing up at these different events, my dude sitting to the side thinking, okay, she's pretty now. She came here by herself. What's wrong with her? And then I'm light-skinned, too. So they think light-skinned chicks crazy anyway. Yeah. Shout out to all our red bones. We ain't crazy. But you know what I'm saying. Do you ever, look, and they in here agreeing. They laughing. It's some truth to that myth. Is it? No. I'm not crazy.
No comment.
Everybody crazy though. Everybody crazy.
Leave it to Charles to be diplomatic. Everybody crazy.
I got a little crazy in me too.
Everybody crazy.
I'm telling you, I come in the club with some house slippers on if you ain't that too long.
Some footies.
Hey, come on now. We both be at home.
Coming up, basketball shorts.
Hey.
I put the basketball shorts
and
on.
And then I mix up my brands. I have on Adidas t-shirt tonight to show. We're going to have a problem.
Chicago Bulls shorts, Los Angeles Lakers top. Jordan Kobe.
And LeBron ain't nowhere, man.
And LeBron headband.
Hey.
Oh my God.
Yes.
Shout out to King James.
I was Golden State. I'm just stepping in my I'm Curry. Man. Anyway. But yes, indeed.
Light skin. I think she's skin racist,
right? Man, I'm not skin.
Light skin with her. I'm just dark as I want to be up here looking like patent leather.
I'll be looking at my microphone.
Patent leather.
No, it is.
Okay, but seriously, do you look at, would you look at a woman initially and say, okay, like, V did, he a guy. Yeah. Something wrong with her. Yeah. Or, you know.
We've been somewhere and we seen him walk in, we was like, man, she.
Something wrong.
Something ain't right.
Yeah.
You know what's so sad, y'all? My beautiful people that are listening to this broadcast, that are listening to Style Behavior, they're telling the truth. They are not flinching. They are not hiding under the table. They are really telling the truth. We need to link this over the ground today and make this just a conference.
We'll
a tell the truth conference.
We're coming through. Keep going. Honey.
Let me know when.
Because TJ done fell up and through here with She Social. Yeah, we representing all through here black business empowerment.
Is that nighttime or daytime?
Yeah, there you go.
Love it.
Yes, talk to him, DJ. You DJ.
All right. I see it all the time.
Okay.
Women that I know have a beautiful spirit, beautiful soul.
Okay.
Outward-wise, they need a little help on something, whatever the case may be.
Yeah.
We as humans ain't going to go over there to this okay-looking person to be like, let me see what her soul like.
Right.
We are superficial.
But brother, on the flip side of that, sometimes if you're intimidated by a woman who's attractive, men don't approach you either. They be like, nah, she got to be. Because seriously, I've even had a friend tell me, well, Sarah, you carry yourself like a married woman. Or I'm like, well, how does that work? And then he said, well, you know, I've had another friend say, well, Sarah, I wouldn't approach you because you just got this, you know. I'm like, okay, I'm not going to not be mean. So I don't know. Maybe the guy's shifting out who need to be there.
Right. Right.
Yeah.
Somebody that is in the public. More often than not, even though I am in the background, I see it more often than not.
Okay.
Men, we all men. We like to go for what's easy first.
Right.
Oh.
Especially in the setting that I'm in. You one or two, you looking sideways, be like, yep.
And it's the truth. Yeah, go ahead.
She just as drunk as I am. She like, yeah. Now, at that point in time, that might not be the baddest person in the club, and it might not be the ugliest person in the club, but it's the easiest person in the club.
Well,
100.
But that's what I'm saying. Now, at that point in time, you got beer goggles on,
right?
And you realize that, oh damn, this was the ugliest one in the club.
Beer goggles.
Yeah, beer goggles.
beer goggles are what you see is drunk vision. Woo, honey.
Oh, yeah, we drunk vision. That's real talk. That's why I don't
drink. So what you saying? So if I'm at what's my place to hang out? Because I'm not really a bar person. Okay, look, check this out. Buffalo Wild Wings, and I'm enjoying the game. And dude won't approach me because I don't look like I'm a happy meal. I ain't look like I'm easy or something. I got to work for that. Okay, I don't feel like working. All
right, after a certain,
we watching the game.
After a certain point, Beyonce turns into Precious. I'm being serious though, and Oprah turns into Felicia. So it don't matter how much money you got after a certain point. I'm gonna put my big boy pants on because I'm drunk enough now. Mm-hmm. Oh, it don't matter.
Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. Confidence builder.
That's exactly what that is. It's liquid courage.
Yeah. Liquid courage. We always need a little bit of that. And with that being said, liquid courage. Well, this is Queen Sara. We're on Stylish Behavior. We're gonna take a break so we can calm down and laugh real hard at the liquid courage we got over here. All right, we're gonna listen to. Oh, I'm trying to see something going on. We're gonna listen to some of this music we've been trying to make work. Most of the program.
Be the song in that event.
All right, we're just gonna wing it. Here we go. All right. Put That Woman First by Jaheim. That's my guy right there. I wanted to marry Jaheim at one point in time. I think I was like 18 or 19. I wanted to marry him. But anyway, speaking of beautiful people we have in the building, and ladies, you can't see him, okay? We got Chief Calhoun in Stylish Behavior, y'all.
How we doing?
Say hey to the people, the beautiful people.
Hey, everybody.
In Real Women Radio Land. Yeah, Chief, tell us a little bit of your business. Okay. Who you are, what you do,
okay.
What's your shoe size? You like mac and cheese?
Okay. I'm size 12 in Jordans, the black and red ones.
Latest, he said 12. A size.
No, yeah. I'm a teacher. I've been teaching for 8.5 years. It'll be my 9th year next year.
He like kids?
I like kids, mine. Everybody else, hell of all the kids. All the kids. Also an aspiring singer, and a personal trainer too. So, that's a little thing about myself.
That's what's up.
Yes, ma'am.
So you can sing to him, and then you can bench press him. That's what's up. and the man's arms are like ripped. But
exaggerating. Go ahead.
But on a serious tip, I'm
the truth. When he walked in, I wanted to do about 4 push-ups.
Don't believe him.
You know how brothers, when you walk in and the bigger dude walk in, you kind of poke your chest out. That's what I did. And I felt like, you know,
look,
I did go to the gym today, but she walked in and kept all my drinks.
And sisters, you know what? I'm going to give a little secret away. We straighten up too. Uh-huh. When we see a brother walk in the room and he fine, he like Mississippi fine, like.
What's Mississippi? That's where
Mississippi,
you're from?
Yeah. I can't you tell? Yeah, we Mississippi fan. Like, we talking about
Real quick.
Okay.
Sweet tea. What's your take on sweet tea?
What's my take on sweet tea?
How much sugar do you need to put in sweet tea to make it sweet?
To make it sweet?
Yeah.
I do Arnold Palmer's. I'm a Southern Belle, but I got a different kind of sway.
So you don't like sweet tea?
I like sweet tea, but I don't.
On the palm, I mean, it got sweet tea in it.
Right. But we don't need to make it syrup.
See, it got to be like a snap away from syrup for me.
Like it's like syrup.
I got a friend in Atlanta, and y'all could be happily ever after with diabetes.
She make good sweet tea?
That girl makes syrup. And I said, Jocelyn, kill us all. If diabetes don't get us first, she probably like, Sara, why are you putting me out there? I love her to death. That's my girl.
Right. That's what I'm saying. I need to make sure I can put my sweet tea on my waffles. You know what I'm saying? That's how thick you need to be.
That's unhealthy.
I make your jaw
go up and down. Just, you know, I'm messing. I'm kidding.
He's not. He dissy.
I'm messing slightly.
You get that euphoric look in your eye when you tell him the truth and you remember you was there. Yeah, that's where he went.
That's why they doing that. We cool. In the gym to work that tea off.
Sure, you got energy. Shoot, that's what you need in your life. Right. All right then, we're gonna bring it all back, Chief. We in here. We know we're talking about how to treat a lady regardless of her appearance. Okay. We've had these married folks give us some perspective. Mm-hmm. I brought Chief here, ladies, because he's single. And that's not a bad thing being single. I'm single. Single's good. Single's great. We're going to get through it. We're going to hold hands.
I mean, don't force it.
Don't force it. I'm not.
If it's not for you at a certain point in time, don't force it. When you force it, that's to be the worst thing.
That's true.
Worst situation.
That's so true. I agree with that 150 million percent. I ain't going to tell you why I agree with that. I digress.
You have to, man. I'm 11 years in this marriage thing.
Oh, wow.
11 years. And you know, that took a lot. Did I say a lot? I took a lot of prayer. I'm sorry.
No,
she
you
good. She good. She good people. I like a lot. We had a lot of life.
She's gonna give us a different perspective because it is a different perspective. We gonna whip Charles. Okay. Go tell us what you know, Chief. How to treat a lady
regardless of appearance. I mean, you gotta take it from like back to home training. Like, how would you treat your mom? You know,
that's what's up.
It starts with that, and you know, if because she's gonna be somebody's mother. She's somebody's daughter. Right. You know, somebody's sister. So you gotta treat her like that because a lot of guys, people in general, we always have an ulterior motive, like regardless of the situation, and we'll see a person that we like to look at. Mm-hmm. She shouldn't get that exceptional treatment, you know. And let's say someone that doesn't catch your eye, you still treat the same thing with respect, you know. Because I have flaws, you know. I used to, let me see if I can do this without putting nobody out there. I had experience in explosive situations, volatile situations,
right,
where you know yelling came into place. No, nothing physical, just
right.
Yeah, I came from a yelling background, mm-hmm. So that's all I knew, you know. And
right,
transitioned out of that. And it took time, and it took the person that I was volatile with. It's like, listen, you know, just out of respect as a woman.
Right.
And I'm like, you're right. And then plus, it helped me with my kids. Cause I was a coach, too. So that's all I knew.
Women Radio World. See, me and Chief could not be a couple because I'm loud anyway. I'm loud anyway.
And that's cool. Some people can rock with that, like
back
and forth, you know. Because I know I was like loud and boisterous.
Right.
She was like, just stop yelling. I said, well, I can't stop. I just can't turn it down.
Right.
It's got, you know. but the dangerous part of that though is that, you know, it's aggression.
Right. Right.
And then aggression can easily transition to something that
it shouldn't
be. Because even like I said, I'll never, you know, hands behind my back. Y'all seen baseball before, right? You know how like the guy, umpire's face. But what does he do? He puts his hands behind his back. You can yell, but don't put your hands on him. See, easily though, you know, with our women, we don't want to make them feel intimidated. We don't want to make them feel scared. Like at the end of the day, we're their protector, you know.
Right.
And at the end of the day, if they're home with us, we shouldn't make them feel scared whatsoever. So that's why I'm like, okay, yeah. I can have a brash tone with you if I'm upset. Because I was telling her, I was like, listen, I'm human, right? We are wired, programmed with these emotions. I can't just sit here and talk to you like this the whole time.
Right? Right.
I'm going to have an elevated tone, you know?
Right.
So, you know, but at the end of the day, we got to make sure the woman that's with us feels some type of protection and safety.
Right? Yes, because I know for me, and I'm going to address one of the questions. One of our listeners from Washington, D.C., y'all.
We in Washington, D.C.,
boys. Okay, we had Mary Triary. She asked the question, she's, you married, can you redate your husband? Can you go on a first date? And can you take
the kids?
But
don't take the kids. No.
That ain't no date.
No.
It's a field trip.
No. What's the purpose of going on a date if you're going to take your kids?
I can see Jabria. What's your name? What's your name, Mom?
You're supposed to constantly date. You're supposed to keep it different. And go back. That's a beautiful thing. I'm going to tell you, me and my wife's first date was to Dennis to get some ice cream.
Nice.
Wow.
Nobody never knew that. She was like, this dude is really taking me to Dennis.
That's stuff right there. That's my stuff right there.
She loved it, though.
Yeah.
That's what we did.
That's my stuff right there.
And I said, you know what? I'm going to see what I had at. That's why I did it. I said, I'm going to see what I had at. Went there, and man, she talked about to this day, she was like, our first date was a Dennis. People like, oh, y'all didn't joke. he was being cheap. No, I tell everybody. I was thinking what head was it. Mm. You know what I mean? If you going to blow up on me about where we go for a little lunch day, it was just a little lunch day.
Right.
Yeah. And we ain't going to Red Lobster or something like that. Yeah. Then, you know, but man, the way she took it and the way she came at me after I dropped her back to work.
Wow.
Like, well, thank you. You know what I mean? Yeah. And no kissing or nothing was involved.
Wow.
She like, thanks. She gave me a hug and she walked off. And then I heard Usher. There goes my baby.
Hey. Do y'all really hear that song? Like, when you see a certain woman, do you really hear a song off in your head? Do you like make videos in your head and stuff like off? Oh, yeah. Like for real? Do you just light up? Because you know my song is true. Every time I think of you, day man, I light up like a Christmas tree. I almost had a wreck. Like, wait a minute. Yeah. Like, I was like, Jenna, like this woman, yeah. That's not romantic. Somebody fell out of bed.
He up there dancing, man. He got in the combat boots.
What's this?
He got a bandana around the head or something. Look, Frank got a playlist.
He and DJ Wing asked him, you know, this fool said, I killed the vibe.
He got different mixes with his old lady. He go from the wobble. The wobble.
Okay, we're going to bring it on back. Okay. Because these ladies are itching to know this stuff. Because, you know, our thing is we want to figure out what is it. You know, because lemonade scared the hell out of everybody. I'm going to be honest. I'm like,
what do you mean by that? Why did it scare everybody?
Why does it scare? I'm going to tell you.
I think I know about one from a woman's perspective. Why?
Seriously? I'm going to give you my perspective, too.
Here we go. We listen.
Okay.
We got all ears.
I am, and I'm not boasting at all, but I am very lettered. I own my own business, been pretty self-sufficient. I don't throw that in the man's face, and I know the art of submission and know how beautiful it can be. Okay. Now, and you are all these things, and I can make some beans and rice and fry some chicken, and I can flip it around on you, get you some healthy stuff, too. I can make you a smoothie if you need it, too.
Yeah.
And you keeping it fun. You got poles in the room and swinging stuff. I ain't telling mama, baby. But you keeping it, you know what I'm saying, fellas.
Right.
I got it.
And you step out. Why? Like, if it's like, why? Like, okay, you got the baddest chick in the game. And like, if women look at Beyonce, and we admire her. To be honest, because even her...
This one.
Hush.
She gonna get shot.
You
soon to get home.
But you look at right now. even when she had a miscarriage, you had a lot of women who said, wow, it's not a class thing, sure. It's not a social political thing, it's just a woman's health thing. And they look at her and say, okay, I can be her, or I can be like her, or if nothing more, I can achieve my dreams. And it's like, if she is what we regard as wow, then he dog her out, and we like, dang. My little self ain't got a chance. Speaking that's how you. That's
yeah.
how you feel.
I got, yeah, yeah. You know what I'm saying? And I thought that was the sentiment was.
Yeah. Right, like, dang, they cheat on Beyonce. What to do with me? I'm a little raggedy self.
Every man's dream woman is somebody's nightmare. Every man's dream woman is somebody's nightmare.
Okay.
Now, don't get it twisted. I'm not saying Beyonce's anyway, because I don't personally know Beyonce or Jimmy, whatever. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, she could bring that boss mentality home. Nobody wants a boss at home. They want a woman. They want their woman. You can go out. You can have a Fortune 5 company. You could be the first female president. All right, cool. You've been with me since... I mean, I've been married for 14 years now. You've been with me for this long, and now you're president? Nah, dude. We was here back before all of that. You still Rachel to me.
Okay, so this brings up another question. Okay. And this is the reason I am honestly not dating. Because I seriously believe that what a person needs on the way to success versus what they need when they actually get to that point is different and it changes. And sometimes your spouse or your significant other may not know how to accommodate that. Do you think that's a part of it?
Well, I think that, you know, because there's layers to dating. There's no silver bullet. There's no, hey, read this book, you have a successful relationship. At the end of the day, we're all spiritual people here, and, you know, it's who God, you know, chose for you. Right. And for you to trust and believe that and be in line with that, for one. But getting back to the layer, I mean, if you want to speak on a carnal sense, speaking back to Jay-Z and Beyonce, Jay-Z was attracted to her. That's it. She could have been like, well, you know, I smoke crack and, you know, I do heroin. Yeah. He wouldn't have cared. She's so, you know, visually.
He saw physical.
And that's it. And really? that's how I'm telling you. Because remember that little men's forum? I'm going to just rehash that real quick. What happens is that we, as women, y'all know what y'all want first. Instead of that, y'all are more mature. Y'all just know because y'all probably been hurt first. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Because just emotionally, genetically, with estrogen, y'all want to be attached to somebody. That nurturing, y'all, you want a boyfriend to hug and hold. That's why these boy bands are so popular. Like, you know, they go nuts. You don't see dudes fainting over that? Like, it's just wired program. So it's they want a guy, right? So they're gonna just hop on any dude that comes away and shows them some type of attention.
Okay.
Let's say they find this cute guy that shows them attention. Okay. I got him, right? They haven't assessed him. They haven't done anything. They haven't, you know, broken them down when they're young, you know, teenage, whatever. And the guy's like, okay, cool. I'm with you because I know I can have sex now easily. Versus like trying to be out here. I'm a teacher. I hear it. I trust me.
Okay.
And like and they take advantage of it. It's a two-thing relationship.
Right.
Women want men, or girls want boys for this. I have a man. I have a time.
Okay, so for the guy, it's like, okay, I know you're gonna be over here every Tuesday and Thursday. And for the woman, it's like, you're gonna hold me after I come over here every Tuesday and Thursday.
Look at social media. How many couple selfies do you see getting posted by more women or more men? The women do it more.
Wow.
It's a thing. You're a thing.
I'm not labeling, it's not every woman, I'm just saying how it starts.
It's how it starts. I mean, when you grow, you mature, you do find out what you want, you know. And so they get hurt first. So now they're like, okay, I don't want a man that is inconsistent. Check. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Next relationship, you know, he's, you know, aggressive or doesn't show them attention. Yeah, man with attention, check. So now they already got two things checked. Consistency, attention, they know. And us women, I mean, men, what do we see? We see a nice-looking woman with, you know, women accessories. You get what I'm saying? We still don't know. We good. As long as you got those accessories, as long as you look good or pleasing to the eye, we still rolling. We still rolling. We haven't matured. We haven't grown yet. We still rolling because they're taking us, right? But what we have mastered is the art of persuasion. We have mastered how can we talk to you and woo you. The path of a man to date you because he likes you, in the path the man takes to have sex with you is the same path. Up until you have sex with you. Then he tries to figure out you after that. And I'm talking about not all men, it's just the young ones.
So does the 90-day period make a difference at all?
Don't you know 90 days. Don't you know 90 days. I don't believe in rules. I don't believe in, like, again, like...
No God.
Like, and even what I'm saying, take it with a grain of salt. Like, you have to figure out what's going on.
Yeah.
But some
you didn't clear some stuff up for me. I'm like, that's what's happening.
It's because it's not our fault. We're not trying to dog y'all to play you.
Right.
That's how we're wired. We just see you. You know, you're beautiful. Like, your skin tone, like how your lip shape. I don't know nothing else about you, so I'm trying to get to know you. But,
Wow.
Day one, y'all like, I need a boyfriend day one. Us, day one, I don't know, but at the end of the day,
so it's like y'all are not thinking that deep, and we're overthinking from the rip.
You tell me first date. What your girls call you? How I go? Right? Can you see something? You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Y'all already planning.
Right.
We're not.
We gonna have perfect go away. Mermaid.
You know what I'm saying? So y'all already there. We just don't know. It's not that we dogs are playing.
Right.
We just don't know. But we're still gonna court you, be respectful, open doors, buy you candy. You know what I'm saying? We're still doing the things.
Right.
Okay.
Right. And
it's doing it to get to what you want to do.
But we don't. All we do know is sex is good. right? Well. If all else fails,
I think there was amen in court, but okay.
And if all else fails, at least we can have this physical situation,
right?
See what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So there's still a goal with women, like, oh, you know, sometimes y'all cut it off first date, you know what I'm saying? Right or wrong,
it's true though.
Y'all cut off first date. Oh, I don't like how some shoes look. Oh, I don't like how we. You know what I'm saying? Y'all cut off. Why? Because you can't see yourself with a guy like that.
Wow. Let me have.
Yeah, see? Because you're right.
Yeah.
You want
to. Wow.
Yeah.
When you think about it, you go back. What age were you when you said, you know, what color you want your wedding and what dress you want to wear in your wedding? How old were you?
Seriously? Wow. What? 12, 13.
I didn't know what colors I wanted for my wedding until we finna get married.
Yeah, like, I didn't even want
to. And like, baby, because I've been married.
Okay,
okay. Baby, I wear whatever you want me to wear. Just when we go on honeymoon. Yeah.
Yeah. You know, all I said was, let me find a DJ. You know, that's all I knew.
That's right. The DJ and the champagne, it was. Yeah.
All I know
baby, you got that.
My wife had a binder.
Come think of it.
A binder the size of Jesus.
Yeah.
I say, what is all this?
Man.
Just tell me when I'm tasting the cake.
Right.
Y'all ain't telling the truth.
And I'm going to tell my boys when they touch
it. Y'all need to be recording this. They telling the truth. This is better than a Steve Harvey exclusive. I'm looking in these brothers' eyes. They telling the truth. They are keeping it real on Real Women Radio. They are telling the truth.
Yeah.
Dude, I've done thousands of weddings, like no lie, in my 23 years of DJing. And I can honestly say 97% of the time, the groom has nothing to do with the wedding.
Yeah.
I'll walk in the wedding, and he'll be standing there, and I'll be like, hey, check this out. You know where my table is?
That's just.
Oh, that's why the high
chair. See,
just bring it in.
That's just too much. You don't know what. Come on now.
Yeah,
I'm being serious.
He just show up.
I mean,
dang, I had
that's how it's set up.
Yeah,
y'all set up. That's how.
Wow,
it's just
Chief is 100% right, man.
I mean, I'm not knocking because that's the truth.
Yeah, but it's not a bad.
He didn't tell us something.
A bad thing. It's just the way we're wired. So that's why you got to be careful in those steps. You got to realize, okay, is this someone I can see? But I understand that y'all are already there, but you also got to take the cues from him too.
Mm-hmm.
Like challenge him. Say, hey, what are you trying to do out of this? Because we don't know. We're going to charm you, your pants off, smile. But
Chief,
but
everything's going so smooth, and I don't want any turbulence. Right. And I don't want to challenge
you. Do it now. Do it now so you don't do it later.
Right.
But I don't want. But I.
Right.
But,
we want you to.
But so what? I mean,
let me tell you something.
The you know what is good, and I don't want to get it off. Oh my goodness.
Listen.
It's just.
Listen.
That's how women sometimes.
Right. But that's how players become players, though, because. They're never challenged.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of girls, they say, well, I'll do this and this and this. And they have these standards in these boxes, but they'll never follow it because they don't want to rock the boat. Like you said, it's a whole bunch of elements of relationships, right?
He won't call me Friday.
Stop. You have to challenge them. So what are we doing? Like, not after sex. Not that. So what are we? Yeah. Afterward. Don't do it. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. God's like, oh, what? Right. After that. Yeah. So you. Right, like, so what do you mean, you know.
Theo didn't change.
Yeah.
Theo done went into X-Men mode.
Yeah, and like, look.
You done brought something out this brother. He was all Cornel West before you came in here, Chief. Yes, and you love your wife, and you do this.
I'm checking my Facebook status.
And he was, yes, and we pour in the community, and we're the hungry brothers, and we look at restaurants. And he done came in here, and he done got black men gone wild. You done brought something out my boy over here.
But
he came about to blaze his shoes off. Yeah.
But y'all have the key to everything, key to life. I'm not trying to be cheesy right now, but sex don't happen unless you give the green light.
That's right.
You know, so you have to challenge him and just at least throw that out there so he knows you want something too. Because you think, oh, I don't want to scare him off. I remember I was talking to somebody, I swear, last week, and she's a lot of women give in to pressure because they don't want the guy to go.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the scariest because I never knew that.
I don't.
Had I. But I mean, you know what I'm saying? But that's a. But you're a grown woman, mature. You know what I'm saying?
I ain't got time for that.
Yeah.
Black women grown man business.
But what I'm saying is that you still have to put it out there.
Yeah.
You know, and don't wait till after sex. After that, it's over. Because now he's trying to make his mind up. Right. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I got what I want.
And he got you like this.
Yeah, now yeah.
He got you like this.
You operate off a straight feeling.
Yep. Yeah.
And you know feelings like light switches.
Yeah, you know, check your Facebook.
That's
crazy.
We talking about
the
social media.
That's crazy.
That new
boo.
We
have
social media.
I'm like Oprah. I got a statement. Y'all ain't gonna see him until the wedding. I don't know. I like that kind of. Okay, you don't know. Yeah. You don't know. I think that's cool.
I love that.
You don't know.
Right.
You don't know.
I wish I could date it before social media. I really do. I wish I could date it in the 70s. There was no Facebook, no nothing.
Where you went on a date.
Yeah. It's
the woman wore a dress.
Right. Right. Just, I've never heard this expression like, you know, why you hiding us? What you hiding? You met my mom already. You know my boys. How am I hiding you? Because you don't post me on social media. What do you mean? You know what I'm saying?
It's just real.
Like,
yeah.
It's that because I can't go back to my grandparents. Like, what? How did grandma feel when she was hiding from Facebook? He like, what? You know? Right. It's a different. It's another element to it now. We have to respond to.
I can't tag you in the post.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
That's a big picture you like. You know.
Unfortunately, man, social media is a big one.
It is. Yeah.
You gonna have us back?
I know we got. I gotta have these fellas back. I gotta thank the Hunger Brothers for stopping through on Stylish Behavior. My man Chief Calhoun came through here and dropped some heavy knowledge on us and gave us some perspective. You are listening to Queen Sara, Stylish Behavior, and you listen to Real Women Radio. You had a good time and you had it with us. Make sure you check us out on social media. I think everybody in here has something on Facebook. Please go on Chief Calhoun's page. He drops all kinds of bombs of knowledge all the time. Stuff to make you just seriously think. Seriously, check out Charles Booking. Hey, Book Chief, he can sing. There you go. They sing Bar Mitzvah family reunions. You know 4th of July coming up, and them fish fries coming up. Y'all need some entertainment. Don't have your uncle move up there singing, and he ain't got his teeth in. You know what I'm saying?
With the barbecue sand alone.
Them sands, he the one from with 2 and 3 East. Yeah. But make sure that you follow not only Stylish Behavior, but the other shows on realwomenradio.com. Thank you, guys. We're going to get up out of here. I don't want to leave. We're having an awesome time. Make sure you check out my girl, TJ, and my man, V. V going to get me because I put him all kinds of out there. But check them on the show next on Grown and Dating. We gave you some etiquette, fellas, on how to treat the ladies. And ladies, we gave you some perspective. Now, stay tuned. Listen to Grown and Dating so you can get a full education of the miseducation of men and women. So this is Queen Sara. Remember, being stylish is a way of life. Peace. See you next Tuesday. On Tuesdays, first, second, and third Tuesdays each month, here on realwomenradio.com. Make sure you check us out. Peace. See you next time.
You know, V don't like.